Hey everyone, this is Joel and I am a trainer with eduphoria. In this video we're going to focus on helping new teachers use Forethought, especially for setting up their lesson planners. When you first log into eduphoria, you're going to see all of the apps on your main screen and you want to click on the application Forethought. And Forethought is the tool that is used for districts to manage their curriculum and also for teachers to manage their lesson plans. Before we get going through the wizard, I want to show you how you're going to navigate the Forethought application. On the far left are these tabs, and they'll let you select different information. For my planner right now, because it's a new planner for you, it is in the wizard mode. After you set it up, you're going to actually see your lesson planner. My activities is where you can search for your activities that will list in here that you create inside of your lesson planner, or you can create in this window here. We're going to have more information that on an upcoming video. You can also search for any activities that your district has created as well. Scope and sequence, this lets you either search by learning standards or drill down through your course curriculum list of courses and go to specific courses to view the information that your curriculum department has curated, that your school has curated over time, and your district has kept, along with the learning standards for those courses. So it just is viewable information for you to be able to access. But again, we're going to focus on this tab for my planner to create your lesson planner that you will use for your lesson plans. So when you first open this, there are no buttons to click here. This is just explaining what you will be doing. So you're going to create a schedule and then you're going to add the courses in for your specific schedule. All of our trainers, all of our training documents about setting up your planner emphasize keeping it very simple for your planner. This may not be the place that you put in, this is my tutorial schedule, this is where I have bus duty, this is where I have lunch. You only want to put in items in your schedule where you're going to be creating lesson plans. Our first step on this screen is to click next, and this is where you're going to give your schedule a unique or distinctive name. You may not just want to put in here my schedule, because you may be sharing your schedule at some point with other teachers. So it's always a good idea to put in your last name and then information about that specific schedule. You can have multiple schedules for your day. Schedules is the container of the courses that you will be teaching. So let's say you're going to be teaching two different subject areas during the course of a school day. You would want to create two schedules. So for right now, the first time you're going through the wizard, it says you will have the option to create another schedule once you are done creating this initial one. So I'm just going to go ahead and create my initial schedule, and I'm going to call this Adkins. That's my user's last name, and it is an English course, or English because we're going to be teaching multiple courses of English in here. So I'm going to put in that name, and then I'm going to click next. Now it's going to ask me to add the entries. And what entries are the specific courses that are going to be taught under the heading of English. If you're only teaching one grade level of English or any of the courses that you're going to be doing, then you would only add one entry, but you can have multiple entries inside of your planner. So for this course, I'm going to say add an entry, and it's going to ask me what type I want to add. For your first one, it's probably going to be a course with learning standards, meaning it's going to tie in the learning standards for the state that you're in to that specific course. A second option is where you can mirror another course. So if you already have created courses, this is basically copying that course into your schedule. And then a special entry is when you might have an area that is tutorials or lunch. Maybe you just like to have filled out schedule in your planner. It's not going to have any learning standards, but it's just a block within the planner that you've set aside to add your own type of notes. So for this, I'm just going to click this first one, keeping it simple, course with learning standards, and then I'm going to click next. And now I'm going to select what I am teaching from the course tree. So I'm at a high school. I said English courses, so I'm going to select English 1, and I'm going to click Next. And it's going to give me the entry title. I want it to reflect that I'm teaching English 1, but you can also customize this if you want to put in another title for this. And then I'm going to click Next. And then I'm going to also add another entry, because maybe in the morning I'm teaching English 1, but I also, in my third period, I have an English 2 class that I'm teaching. So I'm also going to add an entry It's also a course with learning standards, and it is an English 2 course. And it's now showing in my schedule that I have English 1 and English 2. But let's say in the afternoon, maybe I have a health course that I'm teaching. So I'm not going to add that entry here because it's going to go into the container for my English courses. But because it's my first schedule I'm creating, I have to complete this one before I can go back and make any other changes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and click next, and it's showing my English courses that contain English 1 and English 2. And if I wanted to add that health course, then I'm going to go ahead and add that next. And now I can add in the specific learning standards that I'm going to use to teach health. So I'm going to get out of this. I'm going to go back to health, and I'm going to select the health course that I'll be teaching. Click next. It's got the entry title here. Next. It's showing it. If I need to add more entries, I can. If I need to remove an entry, I can. And then I can click next as well. The move up and move down, what that does is it puts it in order for your lesson planner so that when you are filling out your lesson planner, whatever is at the topmost will appear on the lesson planner for you to complete. I'm going to go ahead and click next. And now it's showing my schedule. So I'm going to teach English courses. That's going to be one section of my planner. And then my health courses will be another section of the planner. It's asking the question, do you need to add another schedule? And for time purposes, I'm going to say no. The next button is begin using Forethought. And so now it is showing what I have created for my planner. So when I click on the My Planner tab, when I come into Forethought, this is what will appear because I have created these courses and these entries for what I'll be teaching. If I need to go back and make changes to my planner, I can go down here to change my settings and click on my schedules. And here are my schedules. It's just the wizard again. And now I can click on Edit Schedule, go through the wizard, and select the actual courses that I'll be using if I need to make those changes. So that's how you're going to set up your planner. And again, look forward to more videos showing you how to use your planner.